going to demonstrate how to use the Theragun, or some options of how to use it and apply it for pain relief, to relax muscles, and relieve tension. So we're going to start with treating the back side of the body. You want to, a few things before I make noise with the gun, is make sure you get your patient kind of aligned neutrally, so straighten out their hips, straighten out their shoulders, make sure they can breathe and have a nice long neck. So adjust where you need to. The other thing is you want to make sure to not go over the bony prominences. It's not going to feel good, it's going to bounce off of it and kind of hurt. So you're wanting to hit the soft tissue around those prominences but not go directly on them. The other thing is some areas where there's a little bit of less soft tissue and a little more bony underneath, is angle it. Don't go straight on, it's going to bounce again. So you want to kind of go on the side of the head of your Theragun head of choice. There are different sizes. I'm going to just use the small ball, but go on an angle as opposed to straight on. Okay, so it's going to get noisy, but here we go. And start at the neck. So I'm not on the spine, I'm on the side of the vertebrae spine surface. And going first up to the base of the skull, hitting those several occipitals and muscles that monitor the occiput. I do a little bit of back and forth. I also do a little bit of side to side motion. This area, as you get down towards the inner angle of the focal base, I'm sitting in a really weak position. It's a common place of tension. So the weight is scapulae, I don't need to know. Give you a sign, maybe agree ahead of time if you're making noise, that if you raise their hand, it means something is cool, but they know they can stop right away. So I'm just going up and down on the inner border here, and the shoulder blade. So the other muscles are put tight, and then just shoulders are driving forward and forward. You want to go down the bottom of the shoulder blade, so the shoulder blade is kind of doing a big pony. And then around the lower angle here. And then up the outer border a little bit into that soft tissue. Maybe in that part here, they're so much fat that affects their shoulder or foot or shoulder. They're all feeling the stretch all the time. And then over the back. So that's the thing again, around the shoulder. So you want to look at that shoulder muscle here, the big deltoid. There's so many inner tendons here. This could be sore and tender if they overuse. I want to put that tendon. The whole arm tighter. The back of the arm. The soft. The posterior muscles go. The way to the cup. The back of the finger there. The muscle down. And then again, find that spine of your shoulder blade and roll it under, and then come under it. And get all the new tissue here on the top of the back of the shoulder blade. So, as I come down across, you're pushing the core side of a big thin foot muscle in your back. Tight, and a lot of people. The side of the spine, and I'm going to lift my weight all the way down. And I'm going to lift quite a few layers here of muscle that span the entire chest out. I want to go away with that all the way. And then I'm going to lift the left leg back. And I get down to
here, I'd like to get that quadratus and go into the day. I want you to talk about this muscle. If you really can't lose weight, it's not right. It's only potentially ripping and darting. So a lot of times when you're in, you can have the back pain. So it's important to keep. The other tension way back are the ones that sit here along the back of the hip bone. So we need to do this. Connect. So I want to do a little bit. A little circle moving. And then I'm going to make my way across. You got it. I'm going to make the bar across. If I do, don't you see a corner? You're going to pull the top and and around the hip are a bunch of little muscles that rotate the hip outward. The external is a one kind of go across those up and down to take a good area of body. I'm not going right on the bottom. I'm going where you can cut it between the legs. I'm going to work my way down tight as I like. There's my chin, go back to the top. Now the elbow combo goes after the hip combo here in the buttock. So you don't have to try and get into that a little bit. But then I work my way down. And I'm going to go across and fiber into the next finger. Back side, so you don't have a continuation. And if you're sitting on the other circle, you get the cross up the wall. I would have to have a question. And if you have that knee pain, they tend to have tension in the back here of the knee. So when I really go from rotation moving stand there, there's an action for the hamstrings. There is a really good heel. And then you can have that in there. And so be careful, those top fingers, this is a muscle that could be tense. This is an area behind the knee that has a lot of vascular things. So I don't want to go on it. I'm going to put something on the back foot. I'm going to put it on the back. Two more heads, so I'm going to circle my overhead, and then my inner head. And then I'm going to use the up and down twist with the one feather. And I'm going to take two up and four wrists on the knee. If you think that you send a rotation simulation, you find through the feet. You don't really know you want it. Because it's more difficult, it might be connected to the wrist, so you just want to be careful and pay attention to how you can step them off the bed, and I would know this is probably connected. Yeah. And then I'm going to go through the other side.